A happy morning, children. How did you celebrate your this latest festival? What was that? Makar Sankranti, Bihu, Pongal, and Lohri, isn't it? So these four festivals we have celebrated, isn't it? So you all have celebrated, children? Have you celebrated or not? Yes, what you have taken? What was the special on this festival? Laddu, and with laddu, many more delicious dishes were there. Yes, so have you enjoyed? Yes, so this is our next chapter, means it's our last chapter of English. What is this? Crime never pays. What it means? Crime never pays. Can you understand? Yes, crime never pays means criminals are always punished for their crime. You know, children, if you have done something wrong with others, means surely you will get the punishment. Okay? Or if you do something hasty or hurt someone, something immoral, illegal, sooner or later you will get punished for that and will have to pay the price also. So there is one proverb, as you know, as you sow, so shall you reap. Jaisa बोगे वैसा काटोगे, जैसा जैसी करनी वैसी भरनी. दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोवर्ब्स वी हैव लर्नड एंड वी हैव हर्ड मैनी टाइम्स. ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो डोंट डू द बैड डीड्स, ओके, डू द गुड जॉब. नाउ हियर यू डोंट हैव द पार्टनर, सो दिस इज वार्म अप एक्सरसाइज. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू विद योर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर, श्योर यू कैन डू इट. This is good for you. Clear? Now, as I told you, how many characters are in this play? Because this is play, not a story. Okay? This is play. Play means we can say natak. Okay? So, this is a very interesting play. And how many characters? Four characters are there. Virju, Hira, Ratan and Chief. Chief means head of Madhapur Blaze. We can say sarpanch. For sarpanch in Blaze we say what? Yes, children? Sarpanch. What we say? What we say? Chief. Okay? So Birju and Hiraj, these two are friends. Ratan is Birju's father. It is already written. And we can say these two young men in a Blaze or also good friends. And chief is the head of Madhupur Blaze. Now, what is happening in the first scene? Anyone can tell me what is going to be happen here? Inside of a small mud hut in Madhupur Blaze, Birju and his father are sitting on a couch talking to each other. In what matter they are discussing? You know? Do you know about it? Yes, inside of a small mud. Mud means we can say softer, not muddy area. Okay, it's a soft hut in Madhapur village. Father and Birju, they are talking on a coat. Coat means a bed with high sides, or we can say khatiya, palang. Okay, talking to each other. What they are talking? Now let's start. Birju, first of all, what Birju is telling to his father. Father, I am tired of being poor. Tired of, it's a phrasal verb and its meaning is that you need to take rest or sleep or become bored or not interesting in any kind of work. Okay, so tired of. Father, I am tired of being poor. I want to become rich. Who said? Birju said to his father, Ab main is garibi se ऊब चुका हूँ, बोर हो गया हूँ एंड आई वॉन्ट टू बिकम रिच मैन. आई हैव अ प्लेन. ओके, सो ही हैज सम आइडियाज एंड प्लेन, बट वॉट ही वॉन्ट फॉर दैट? ही वॉन्ट हेल्प और नीड ऑफ हीराज. हु इज हीरा? हीरा इज अ बिरजूज फ्रेंड. सो आई विल नीड हीराज हेल्प फॉर दिस प्लेन. ओके चिल्ड्रन, now Ratan is the father of Birju. He said, You could ask him, means you can ask first. He is your friend, isn't he? He is saying you have to ask first, then you can see the plane and what you want to, how you will take the help of his. So you have to tell about your plane to your friend. He is your friend and he can understand easily, isn't he? Okay, he is your friend. He is asking the question, isn't he? Okay, so just then he has come to visit. He greets them and sat down. First of all, as they were talking to each other at the same time, what happened? Hira comes to visit. Hira came there, okay, and he greets them and sat down. Greets means what they say, like first of all you say good morning, good evening, good night. These all are called greeting words, isn't it? So Ram Ram, as in bliss, we heard this word Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Jai Krishna, Jai Shri Ram, like this. He greets them and after that sit down at the same place there where they were sitting and talking and discussing. Birju, it is good you have come, Hira. What he said? Yes, because he is asking for his help and he need his help. So he said, it is good you have come, Hira. I wanted to tell you my plan to earn some money. What is telling? Who is telling to whom? Birju is telling to Hira, I wanted to tell you about my plan, what I thought, okay, how we can get the money or how we can earn some money. So Hira said, what is plan? Birju, Hira, what do you think of your going to city and finding new ways of earning money? He is saying, I have some ideas and I can arrangement or doing something or achieving something in our future. So we can go for city to finding new ways. New ways, ways means raaste bhi hota hai aur ideas bhi hota hai. Okay? Aur tarike bhi hota hai. Clear? So I have new ways of earning money. After all, we have to look after our family. So if we will get some money, then surely our family will live happily. Clear? Now Hira, that's good idea. Let's do it. What said? Hira said, yeah, that is good. Why not we can do it? Okay, so let's do it. Ratan, God bless you both with help and success. Who said to whom? Who has given blessings to whom? Ratan means Birju's father is giving blessings to both of them for their wealth and success. Stay together and help each other. What he said? After blessings them, he said, you have to stay together. Don't leave alone, means you have to help each other. Don't what? Don't leave to each other. Okay? At the same time, I can say, when you go somewhere or out of home, so what your mama or papa said, you are going to your friend's home, so you have to play each other, okay, study each other, like this. Also, Ratan said to Birju and Hira, means you have to stay together. Clear? Now let's turn your page. Now the two men set off on their journey. The very next day, over the next few months, they get many jobs. As they left the place, what is happening there? They get many jobs. After few months, next few months only, they got the job. And what happened? They are deciding to do something new. Hira is honest and hardworking, while Birju is lazy and careless. So what is the speciality of Hira? Hira was honest and hardworking. But how was the Birju? How was the nature of Birju, we can say? So lazy, he was lazy and careless. Birju always leaves his share of work unfinished. This is the quality of Birju. Birju never finished his work. Why? Himself. He always leaves his share of work unfinished, incomplete. Okay? Which Hira kindly picks up after finishing his own work. And what was the speciality of Hira? Hira, after finishing his work, he immediately takes care of Birju's work and after finishing his own work. A year passes. After a year, what happened? Birju and Hira have earned a lot of money. Okay, they decided to go back to their village. So now after earning the money, they are deciding to go back their village. While returning home, they pass through a orchard. Orchard means it's a piece of land. And we can see it's a which fruit trees are grown. Okay, or we can say orchard means large garden also. There are different kind of fruits and trees. Fruits trees. Okay, orchard means large garden. Close to Madhapur, Birju has an idea. Now what happened? As they reached to place, there was a garden that was large garden. Okay, in that, what happened? Birju said, I have a idea. Birju has an idea. So he said, now what happened? In the scene 2 we will see it. Birju and Hira are in orchard with bags of money in their hands. Okay, they went there, as you can see in the picture. Now Birju, Hira, it isn't wise to take so much money to our homes. Everyone will come to us to borrow money. Let's hide our money bag in a pit under this tree here. So here you can see what they are doing. They are planning something new. As they have lot of money and they have earned lot of money, after it they was talking and discussing to each other why we can take whole money with us. Those who are living in place, they can ask to borrow money. Okay, so they are hiding money bag in a pit. Okay, pit means we can say a hole in the ground. They make a small hole in a ground, that is pit. Okay, a borrow, you know very well, to take or to deceive somebody's. So anyone can ask money, so better to keep it here. Hira, that's a true, Birju. Hira is saying, okay, Birju, you are telling true. You are saying true. Let's bury it here and only take a small amount with each of us. Bury means to put something in a hole in the ground and cover it. Because if they will make it pit or hole, so after it, anyone can steal it. So what they have to do? They have to cover it. So they are saying, okay, we cannot take whole money with us. We can take a small amount with each of us. Now, here what it is written, the two of them dig a pit under a tree and put their bags into it. They cover it carefully with mud and dry leaves and go to their homes in blaze. At night, Birju tells his father about his adventures. Adventures means, you know, it's experience or antic experience. Or unusual experience. It's a whole thing he has said to his father, who? Birju's. Who was the father of Birju's? Ratan. Okay? So after doing this thing, he said to his father, he has done this work. Now let's see the next page. Birju, father, wasn't it a good thing that I took Hira to work in the city? He is asking, father, it was good when I took Hira to work in the city. Now we have so much money. It was entirely my idea. Entirely means completely. Who said? Birju said to his father, I have taken to him to work in the city. So that was my idea, and completely I have given this idea to him. It was because of me that we got all the money. Now he is thinking. What he is thinking? He is thinking, I have given the idea, so that's why all money which we got from there or earned from there means that should be mine. Okay, so then shouldn't it all belong to me, father? He is saying, if I have given the idea, means it should be mine only, surely. Why? Who has taken? That means, how Hira can take it? Because I have given the idea, means idea, if I have given the idea, means I earn the money. Without my idea, how he can get the money? So he is telling this thing to his father. I think I should take all the money from the pet. Who said? Birju said to his father, because he has given the idea to him to do this job, and after doing the job he got the money. So he said to this to his father, I should take all money from the pet. Pet means hole. Okay. Ratan, clever boy, go quickly then. Who said? Ratan also said, okay, you are very clever boy, now go and take it from there. So it is dark. Birju takes a spade. Spade means a sharp tool. Phavda jisko bolte, that you are for digging, that we have to use for the digging. Okay, so he is doing the same and giving the advice to his son. Goes to the orchard and takes out all the money. He put back the empty bags and cover up the pit as before. See the cleverness of who's Birju, isn't it? Okay, because Birju, how was the Birju children? He was careless and lazy. So he has said, I have given the idea, so why not we can't take it? Okay. Now, a few days later, Birju meets Hira in the blaze. Okay. So after a few days, as you meet with your friends, same, Birju also meets Hira's in the blaze, the same blaze, because they were living in the same blaze. Now, Birju, Hira, I need some money for daily needs. For purchasing the daily needs like sugar, oil, pulses, rice. Okay. So he needs money for it. Let's go and take out some money from the pit. Birju said to whom? Hira, I want some money and I need some money for daily needs. So now let's go and take some money from the pit. Okay, so now they are discussing about the money which they had hidden in that pit. Okay. Hira, sure. I too need to take out some money. Let's go now. Okay, so they are going to take the money where they have kept. Now, in the fourth scene number 4, what happened? In the orchard, they dig open the pit. They see an empty bag because they have hidden full of, means half of the amount they have kept their butt. Now, how was the bag? The bags were empty. Shouting, Birju was shouting, the money has been stolen. turning angrily to Hira and saying, as you can see in the picture here, how he is looking at him. "You thief! You have stolen my money. Come on, give it back to me. You can't take my share." See the cleverness of Birju, how he is shouting and turning angrily to him, and you are blaming to Hira, "You are thief and you have taken my money. How can you take my money and my share?" Okay, now Hira, "Hey, wait Birju, I haven't stolen the money. Don't insult me. I am not a thief." So Hira also said, "No, I have not taken the money and I have not stolen the money. Why you are insulting me? I am not a thief." Okay, so Birju said, "Oh, you are lying." Lying means to speak falsely, telling lie. Okay, you are telling lie. "Only you know about this pit. Give me my share or I will take you to the village chief." So now he is telling, "If you will not say truly, means surely, I will give this matter or I will put this matter in front of the village chief." Okay, "Fine, let the chief decide." Hira said, "Okay, no problem. You can say this matter in front of chief. Chief will decide what will happen." So now what is happening in the next scene? Let's see it. Okay, they go to the village chief. He listened to them and think of ways to find out who the thief is. When Birju makes a suggestion, he says that the tree goddess would have seen the person who stole the money and might help them. The chief decided to go to the orchard the next day and to hear what the tree goddess has to say. At night, Birju tells his father his plan. All the things as Birju told his father. Okay, so now chiefs decided to go to the orchard, and who will be there? There will be the tree goddess, and he will say about all situation and all about this matter. Okay, now let's turn the page. Now in scene number 5, the next morning, Birju, Hira, the village chief and other villagers are in the orchard. They were there in the orchard. Now, "Chief, oh tree god, tell us who stole the money from the pit beneath you." Beneath you means under you or below you or lower down, we can say. "So you can tell me the correct thing or the thing which we can find from you, you can say it." Voice from the tree, "Hira, Hira, Hira." Now, who was the thief? Voice from the tree, it is coming Hira. On hearing this, the village chief wonders how the thief may be punished. Everyone else, however, is shocked to hear the tree talking. Nobody sees Hira lying dry sticks and leaves around the speaking tree and setting it on fire. As you can see here how he is doing. The flames of the fire reaches the tree. So he has done all the things. Now, voice from the tree. "Oh, help me, help me, I am burning, help." Who was inside? Now you can see Ratan falls out the hollow trunk of the tree, badly burnt. So now who was the thief? Ratan, because he was there. There means in the hollow trunk where they kept the money. Okay? Okay children, understood? What is happening? Yes. A flame means an area of bright burning that you know very well. Guess that comes from something that is on fire, flames. Okay, any other difficult word is here? Punished, you can you know very well what is punished means, teach someone a lesson. Sticks also, you know, piece of wood from a tree. Got it? Yes, lying means settle or put down gently or carefully. Okay, now what is the next thing? Let's see, it is going to finish. Oh, so you pretended to be the tree goddess? Well, you deserve the painful one as punishment. Okay, who was there? Ratan. Okay, as tree goddess. So Cheep said, yes, this is your punishment and you deserve this punishment to do. So this is your punishment. Now turning to Birju, it's time to punish the real thief. Who said this? Cheep is saying to Birju, this is the real time when we can punish the real thief. Okay, so this is the story from Panchatantra. It is taken from or edited from Panchatantra, but it is not the story here, it is the play. Okay children, so now let's find part of the story which tells you bad deeds are punished. This you can find from the story or this play. Okay, so now you come to know what happened in this play. Who has punished by the thief and who was the real thief, who was honest, who was careless. Okay, everything you know. So whose characters do you like most? Many more conceptual questions I will ask after this video. Till then you can complete this first exercise, understand and answer. Here is a list of qualities that you have to take it. Describe the heroes and put cross next to the to those that describe Birju. You know very well how was Birju and how was Hira, as we have already learnt in this play. So take care, bye bye. Revise this chapter, it is very interesting chapter. Okay, see you, bye bye.